Welcome to the online lecture of Artificial Intelligence, CSE 423, Module 1. In this lecture, we will cover Introduction to Artificial Intelligence and Games as an Application. And in subsequent lectures, we will study Vision and Speech Processing, Robotics, Expert Systems, Natural Language Processing, and Theorem Proving. As we can see that AI has impacted our life in many ways, starting from gaming, astronomy, healthcare, transport, agriculture, education, e-commerce, entertainment, robotics, automotive, social media, finance, and many more. Can you give examples of each of these fields? To name a few, we can have tic-tac-toe from games, remote surgery from healthcare, e-learning from education fields. Definition of artificial intelligence. It is the intelligence exhibited by machines or software. The definition of artificial intelligence is derived from intelligence itself. As we can see that intelligence is the ability in human to learn and solve problems, AI tries to bring these ability in the machines. Another definition by Russell and Norvig is the study and design of intelligent agents, where an intelligent agent is a system that perceives its environment and takes actions that maximizes the chance of the success. These are the philosophies of AI. Think humanly, think rationally, act humanly, act rationally. Think humanly philosophy says the exciting new effort to make computers think, machines with mind. This philosophy says the thinking process of machines should be same as the thinking process of human. Next is think rationally, the study of mental faculties through the use of computational models. This is codification of human thinking process. Expert system is an example of think rationally. This philosophy says that machine's output should be similar to the human output. This philosophy ignores the internal process of the machine. It doesn't say that the thinking process should be similar to the machine. Next is act rationally. Computational intelligence is the study of design of intelligent agents to get the best output by the acting rationally. So the machine should act rationally, no matter if it is working like human or it is generating output like human, it should generate the best output which is possible by the available inputs. These are the various human abilities and their corresponding applications which can bring the ability of the human activities in the machines. For example, human can see through eyes. As AI applications, we have image classification and face recognition systems which can bring the ability of seeing into the machine. The ability of speaking can be brought through this application, which is text-to-speech converter. Human can understand speech, and this ability can be brought into the machine using applications like speech recognition or speech-to-text converter. Human can write. There are machines which can generate handwriting or which can draw. Human can understand written text. There are applications, there are systems which can recognize the handwritten documents or which can recognize the digits also. Human can drive a car. There are various applications which can bring the driving ability in the machines. AI tries to make robots which can perform these physical tasks. This is a famous experiment suggested by Turing to know if the computer is equally intelligent as human. According to the design of the experiment, in one room there is an interrogator and in remaining two rooms there is a computer and human responder, but interrogator is not aware in which room there is computer and in which room there is human responder. To which AI philosophy you can relate Turing test? Think humanly, think rationally, act humanly, act rationally. Okay, the answer is C. How computer is generating the output, how human responder is generating the output, interrogator is truly not bothering about it. Socrates is a man, all men are mortal, therefore Socrates is mortal. This statement belongs to which AI philosophy? It's B. Think rationally. There is a sequence of statements which is concluding something. Can you identify which of the following disciplines of AI are involved in the self-driving cars? Yes, all of the above, image processing, image classification, audio signal processing, path planning, all these are part of an application which are an element of a self-driving car. Now we will see that how AI can help in solving this puzzle. There are 8 tiles placed in a frame and there is an empty space. You can slide these tiles into the empty space. 2 can be brought here, 8 can come here, 4 can come here, 6 can come here, and there is a goal state. Our task is to achieve this goal by sliding these tiles. We are starting from this state, and from this state we can say that there are different successes which can be generated by this state. For example, if we have this initial state, and from this state we can have this state by sliding these 2 down to the middle, or we can have this state by sliding this 4 in the left. We can also generate this state by sliding 6 up, or we can get this state by sliding this 8 in the middle. Similarly, we can generate other states also, and we can construct a complete tree structure of the puzzle. This tree structure of the puzzle is called state space, and in this state space we will be having some states which are equivalent to the goal state. Now our task is to find that particular goal state using some search strategy. How to search for the goal state? Do you think AI is used? Yes, you can use DFS and VFS to find the particular goal state. Do you think AI is being used? No, AI has not been used, because this is exhaustive search and system is not applying any intelligence in searching the goal state. Now this is another version of the solution of 8-tile puzzle. Here this is the initial state which is given to us, and this is the final state which we have to achieve. Now from this particular state we can generate these 4 states as we have generated in the previous slide. We can slide this 8 down to the middle to get this state. We can slide this 1 in the right to get this state, and so on. So these are the 4 states which we can generate from this initial state. But here we are computing one more quantity, and that is the cost of getting goal. The cost of getting goal from this initial state is 3. As we have progressed here, now the cost of getting goal is 4. For this state also the cost of getting goal is 4. For this state also the cost of getting goal is 5. For this state also the cost of getting goal is 5. How we are computing this cost? Consider this goal state, and here we are just counting the number of wrongly placed tiles. For example, in this state we have 2 here, but here it should be 1. So this 2 is wrongly placed here, so we are just counting the wrongly placed tiles. 2 is wrongly placed, this is wrongly placed, 3 is correctly placed, 4 is correctly placed, 5, these are the correctly placed tiles, this is again wrongly placed, and 8 is also wrongly placed. So total wrongly placed tiles are 4. Consider this state, 2, 8, this slide and this slide also. So there are 4 slides which are wrongly placed. Similarly, we will calculate the cost for this state also. At this level, we can see that cost of state 1 and state 2 is 4, and cost of state 3 and 4 is 5. So from this state again, we can generate some other successors and we can compute the cost accordingly. Now at this state we can see that we will be selecting the least cost state. Here we can see that both state 1 and 2 are having same cost 4. Out of these 2 we have to select 1, so we have selected this. From this state again we have generated the 2 states, and for them also we have computed the cost. Here we can see that we have moved to the next level, and we have pruned out, or we have not exploring these states which are below the level 1. We have removed this entire search tree from our search space, so it will reduce the cost. Now what do you think? AI is involved here? Yes, we have used heuristic function. Heuristic function is a function which is computing this cost. So the function which we are using to computing cost is called the heuristic function. So there can be other criteria also, as we have used here the number of wrongly placed tiles. One can use the different criteria also to compute the cost. So that can be the distance of a particular tile from the correctly placed tiles. For example, this 2 is here, but the 2 should be here. The distance of 2 from its correct position is 1. Here we can see that 8 is here, but it should be here. The distance of 8 from its current position is 1. So we can add all these distances to get a cost. So that can be another criteria. Which method it seems to be? Obviously, it is a greedy method, because at each level we are trying to choose a state which is of least cost. So here we have chosen this because it is of least cost, and at this level also the cost of this state is 4, the cost of this state is 6. We have chosen 4 because it is least out of these two. It is a greedy method. It is also called hill climbing, which you will study in subsequent lectures. This is another problem of playing a famous game, tic-tac-toe. This is the initial state of, and now there is X's move, and X can be placed here, here or here. There are three blank spaces where X can be placed. This is the first state where the player has placed X here. In this state, the X has been placed here, and in this state, X has been placed here. So these are the three possible states which can be generated from this. So this was the X's move. Now the next move will be of the opponent. So opponent will always try to defeat you. It will place its symbol at the place which will make winning process difficult for X. So from here you can see that O can be placed here or here, because we have two empty spaces. So O can be placed here, O can also be placed here. From here also you have two blank spaces, so O can be placed here or O can be placed here. So this is the second ply of the opponent. Again there would be X chances. Here you can understand, one player is trying to win the game and other player is trying to defeat the first player. This is a kind of adversarial search in which one ply is increasing the value and other ply is reducing the chances of win. So this problem is different from the puzzle problem, where you don't have any opponent. So how games are different from puzzles? Because in puzzles you don't have any opponent, you just try to solve the problem. But in games you have an opponent. When you are trying to solve the problem, your opponent is trying to defeat you. So games are adversarial in nature. Now how AI can help searching in adversarial search space? So this is a topic of the next lecture, which is min-max search. Thank you.